say after this.
All right, thank you for your attention.
Yeah, sure. We have a few questions.
All right, sure, shoot.
So we have time for questions, which is good. It's very good. Okay, we are, you know, we are a dance group. We are simple that mostly deal with movements of the body and eating healthy and bananas and yeah, we're very physical. Could you just explain a little bit? I mean, we saw the technology that you use, and that's pretty impressive. We would like to maybe just explain to us the idea in a more, let's say, common way, just the ideas that you were thinking of in your choices. Why did you choose, how did you play? Because the sounds were really beautiful. But yeah, how do you see this? What are the ideas that you have in mind when you approach this project?
Okay, I've been to a few dance performances, and usually the music there, where I myself find it interesting, is when the music is it's not classical. It's quite weird, and I think that goes beautiful together with like a modern dance performance, like people that are good with jumping and ballet and that kind of stuff, and see how they react to something uncommon in a way.
Okay.
But I see I could react also like in terms of how crazy it is and the tempo. I think the tempo and the space will mean a lot to the dance performance.
And how do you see yourself interacting, or in what way are you kind of communicating or interacting with our dancers?
Like I'm think of mood, whether it is something slow and beautiful. Mm-hmm. I can have something that is more clean. If it's more crazy, I might. And they might also respond to the music they hear, or I hope they will.
Okay. And what exactly do you control with your touch screen? I mean, what do you do with the sound in the space, or do you control the actual sounds that you're
making? Yeah, both, yeah.
Okay, it's good actually. It makes you pretty fast, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. It's not as responsive as a mouse in a way, but I can control more parameters at the same time, which I find very interesting.
Okay, good.
Yeah, I have a question. When we were sitting here, the surround, in that exact spot, the surround was working beautifully. But when I was going there, like being one of the dancers, it did not feel like that. And I'm thinking it's this PA system, but maybe how do you see that in your performance?
Yeah, actually, the idea could adapt to more speakers, and they would get more of a monitor signal, because you're missing the front signal in a way, or just have one speaker like above them that react as a monitor for the overall signal.
Is the music you played, is that something you recorded in advance, or is that something that you just now played for us?
Yeah, it is basically one FM synthesizer. Uh-huh. The RP that is arpeggiated in a 7B5.
7B5.
Yeah, and that was pre-planned.
What is 7B5?
It is a chord.
Oh, okay.
So it's a selection of notes. but everything else was was done on the spot. And I would work, a lot of the effects are time-based, not only in the space, but also the modulation of the sounds.
So some of the movements, when you were moving the sound in the space, some of it was automatic, and some of it was controlled by you.
Yeah, well, I've been thinking of all the concepts, but yeah, so essentially I can delay the affected signal between the back and the fourth. I have a knob for that.
Yeah.
And I can also I can record a movement I'm doing and let it repeat, so I don't have to do it again and again if I want.
Our performance, this is probably going to be my last question, I'm sorry I'm keeping you, but our performance is going to be very improvised at times. Do you think you will be able to react on surprises from our dancers? They tend to sometimes push things a bit over the top.
Yeah, in my own way, I think I'll be able to do that in one interesting way.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you.